Welcome to the 700 Club. The FBI has arrested an Ohio man for plotting an attack on the U.S. Capitol building. His plan was to set off pipe bombs inside and then gun down as many government officials as he could.
20-year-old Christopher Cornell expressed support for ISIS on Twitter, but he's described as a lone wolf with no formal ties to any terror group. Caitlin Burke brings us the story.
An Ohio man is behind bars today, accused of plotting a homegrown terror attack. Authorities say he wanted to wage jihad in the U.S., inspired by Al-Qaeda and ISIS.
You wouldn't think Cincinnati, Ohio, jihadist in the same sentence.
According to the FBI, the plan was a deadly assault on the U.S. Capitol building and members of Congress. The suspect was arrested Wednesday after buying two M15 assault rifles and 600 rounds of ammunition. He's identified as 20-year-old Christopher Lee Cornell. Authorities say he publicly supported the Islamic State, and he'd been posting disturbing messages on Twitter. One stated, "I believe we should just wage jihad under our own orders and plan attacks." A beginner's hand guide to Islam was among the things taken from Cornell's apartment.
He had just recently converted to Islam, and he had been talking about it for a few months. He's a good kid. He's been kind of lost.
Meanwhile, Nigeria's homegrown Islamic extremist group Boko Haram is also acting more like ISIS, declaring an Islamic caliphate and launching widespread attacks across countries in East Africa. Girls as young as 10 are being used as suicide bombers, and the number of attacks is increasing. In one of their most recent attacks, jihadis massacred up to 2,000 people.
Despite the deadly terrorism in Paris and the Muslim attacks and violence around the world, the White House refuses to use the words radical Islam to describe the terrorist, even when they themselves say they're acting on behalf of Islam and Muhammad. Caitlin Burke, CBN News.
I don't agree with this newspeak coming out of the White House. Put it in other terms, what do you think of when you hear the term radical Baptist or radical Catholic? What do you think of? You certainly don't think of somebody trying to plot an attack on the U.S. Capitol. There's a reason Islam seems to spontaneously produce this kind of behavior, and you find it in the words of the Quran. That's the source, and Jesus told us to judge trees by their fruit, and this is the fruit of Islam. In other news, the United States is battling a major flu epidemic. Here's John Jessup with more on how to fight it. John?
Gordon, the flu epidemic is so severe that the Centers for Disease Control says it's widespread in almost every state. And as Lori Johnson reports, new antiviral medicines could make the difference between life and death.
Nearly 30 children have died from the flu so far this season, including 5-year-old Scarlett Taylor of Tacoma, Washington.
I feel like, you know, if I would have known more about this flu, you know, maybe I would have taken her to the doctors on Wednesday instead of Friday.
The flu vaccine does not protect against the strain of flu Scarlett had, H3N2, which is sweeping the country.
Antiviral medications like Tamiflu and Relenza can reduce the severity of the flu. There are a couple catches. You need a prescription, and you should start taking them within 2 days of developing symptoms.
Flu symptoms include fever, aches, and fatigue. People who benefit the most from antivirals are those at greatest risk of dying from the flu, people over 65 and the very young, also folks with chronic issues like diabetes, asthma, and heart disease.
To prevent catching the flu in the first place, wash your hands and load up on vitamins through food, supplements, or both. Lori Johnson, CBN News.
In other health news, not getting enough exercise could be twice as deadly as being obese. Researchers at Cambridge University in Britain studied information from more than 330,000 European men and women and found that twice as many deaths were linked to a lack of exercise compared to obesity. But they also found just a little bit of exercise, like 20 minutes or more of walking, can seriously cut the risks of early death, especially for people who already spend much of their time sitting. And if you can't walk 20 minutes at a time, experts recommend splitting it up 10 minutes twice a day. Well, those are today's top stories from CBN News. Gordon and Terry will be back with more of the 700 Club after this.
The Third Target, a new novel from New York Times bestselling author Joel C. Rosenberg. After years of war, the world awaits an era of peace. But there is a new threat. A dangerous Islamic offshoot of Al-Qaeda is rising. What if ISIS captured chemical weapons? The Third Target from Joel C. Rosenberg. Another adrenaline-charged political thriller snatched from today's headlines. The Third Target. Now available at your favorite retailer or at joelrosenberg.com. joelrosenberg.com.
Hello, my name is Paddington.
On January 16th.
How would you like to come home with us?
Oh, yes, please.
Critics are unanimous. Paddington is absolutely charming.
But I hope I don't look weird.
Outrageous, wonderful, never before seen. It has style and magic. 5 stars. The producer of Harry Potter does it again. A magical experience you will never forget that might just melt the heart.
That was amazing.
Paddington, rated PG, January 16th.
Does God still heal today?
I knew that something miraculous had happened to me.
I was born deaf, and then my ears got healed.
You know, you can put your trust in medicine, but the ultimate healing is going to have to be God.
When they took that second scan, and it came back completely negative, like just gone.
Find out how God still heals today in Pat Robertson's latest teaching, Be Healed, available now.
Well, newlyweds hear it all the time. The first year of marriage will be the hardest. Well, that was definitely true for Tom and Corrine because they spent the first year of marriage with no job and almost no money.
When Tom and Corrine DeNegri married in 2007, they looked to their future with anticipation and uncertainty because just a month before their wedding, Tom was laid off from his job in magazine sales.
There was about a year and a half where there was zero income coming in, and that was a struggle. It drained a lot of money. It hurt.
What made it more frustrating was that Corrine, a Canadian, couldn't even take a job because her U.S. citizenship hadn't been finalized. But the couple found encouragement watching the 700 Club.
We needed to hear positive things, and we needed to know that God is at work, even when it looks like things are very down.
Despite living off their savings, they decided to become CBN partners.
I believe in CBN. I trust them taking the money out, and then I trust them to put it to good use, to do the Lord's work. They do all of that.
For months, Tom couldn't find steady work and grew frustrated as their savings dwindled.
I was living in fear. I was living in anxiety. In fact, anxiety was my normal. We watched every nickel and dime we spent. We cut down everything that was not necessary.
Finally, he told Corrine they needed to stop giving.
That's it. We got to tighten everything up, cut all loose corners, cut all the costs, cut everything down to bare bones, including CBN, including everything.
Right away, I went into prayer because that's what I know to do, is to pray and to say, God, just work in Tom's heart. Let him know that you are a provider and that when we give, you can intervene and be a part in this.
That same day, Tom says he had a change of heart. First, he surrendered his financial situation to God. Then, instead of cutting out their giving, he decided they needed to give more and went online to increase his pledge to CBN.
It was a major commitment when I hit that button because I know every month $100 is being taken out. It's committed, it's done. But there was a shift going on. There was a wonderful shift that goes on because I went from being desperate and being wanting to take money, now I became empowered. Even though I was still in the same situation, I was empowered to give. I was now a giver.
And I was like, yes, God. When he said, let's give more to the 700 Club, I'm like, yes.
Tom says God then opened the door for a new career as a business analyst. It started when he discovered a free college course online. He took the course and landed a great paying job that turned out to be a perfect fit.
As I started getting into the job, all my skills, all my job experience, they all dovetailed into this job. I never thought in my life that this would ever happen.
In just a few months, Tom received 3 promotions with pay raises. Tom and Corrine say their decision to trust God through giving opened the door to the blessings they have today.
There's only one reason, and that's because I surrendered it to God. I'm a steward, and I look back at that turning point is that when I put my hand to give that $100, it was an act of faith. Just by that simple act of faith, God has just favored us so much.
The Bible describes this transformation. You find it in Isaiah 58. I want you to share your food with the hungry and to welcome poor wanderers into your homes. Give clothes to those who need them. If you do these things, your salvation will come like the dawn. Then when you call, the Lord will answer, "Yes, I am here." He will quickly reply. Tom described it. When he started giving, suddenly he was generous. Suddenly he no longer had the same needs, the same emotional outlook towards life. The transformation began with the act of faith to give. And then you get the wonderful promise from Isaiah 58. When you call, the Lord will answer quickly. He will say, "I'm here. I'm here for you." Well, when the housing market collapsed in 2008, many real estate agents struggled to earn a living. Marissa had no idea how she would pay the bills until she found the answer right in her own backyard.
Marissa Volpini is a veteran real estate agent and home builder. She moved here from Italy when she was younger and worked in the business with her husband for decades.
When I just got my real estate license, obviously I didn't have no sales under my belt, and we had no money in our checking account, and we had no food in our refrigerator.
Marissa told a friend about their situation, and that friend called the 700 Club for prayer. A few days later, someone from CBN delivered hundreds of dollars of groceries as a gift to the family. That's the reason Marissa joined the 700 Club more than 20 years ago, and it's why she continues giving today. She talked about helping others the way CBN helped her.
It touches me when I see these poor families, these mothers that have children sick, that need food. My heart goes to them, and I consider check in every month to help out.
Marissa learned about giving early in her career. In fact, she tells the story about the first $20 she ever gave to help the poor.
I felt compelled to give, but I also knew I had no money in my checking account.
Marissa borrowed the $20 to pay the pledge, and the next day at the office, she was shocked when she received a single call that would earn her more than $7,000 in commissions.
It was very exciting because now the first thing I could think about was I could go to the store, I could pay for the utilities.
Marissa and her husband worked together in real estate until 2001, when Rick became wheelchair-bound due to osteoarthritis. In spite of the setback, Marissa continued to give.
So I kept on giving without worrying about receiving because God is faithful, and in due time, He does come true.
Marissa and Rick had built the houses in this neighborhood, and Marissa decided to buy and develop the 17 acres next to that property.
However, the economy sunk, and we were struggling.
One day, as she was refinancing her home to pay some bills, Marissa's banker gave her an idea.
He said to me, "Why don't you sell the leases on your property to gas and oil companies?"
Marissa took his advice and within a few months received a check in the mail for $100,000 for the mineral rights on the property.
Here, God already had given me everything I needed right in my backyard. With the $100,000, we were able to pay everything and everybody and even have extra. Don't be afraid, because when you give, your hand is open to receive the provision that God has for you.
When you give, your hand is then open to receive the provision God has for you. Here's what the Bible says about that. You find it in Proverbs chapter 19. If you help the poor, You are lending to the Lord, and He will repay you. Marisa found that, and she said, I want to help the poor. I want to be a part of it. I've been there. I know what it's like. And when you give to CBN, you're helping the poor right here in America. You're helping feed 3 million Americans every single month. Our food trucks go out to churches, food pantries, food ministries across America, and we want to make sure people have enough food. So if you're a CBN partner, that's part of what you're doing. Well, here are some of our longtime CBN partners, and they want to encourage you to become a partner too.
We are a group of faithful CBN partners. Through the years, we have seen what CBN is doing around the world, and we want to challenge you to join us by becoming CBN partners.
So here's our challenge right now until the end of the hour. We'll match your giving dollar for dollar up to $67,400. So pledge now to CBN, and when you do, we'll be doubling the power of the gift that you give to CBN. Thank you for giving.
Okay, there's the challenge, $67,400. What a challenge means is existing CBN partners like giving to CBN so much they want to challenge others to give. And so for the next 41 minutes and 30 seconds, they'll match your giving dollar for dollar up to $67,400. Let's pray. Lord, we ask for blessing over this and for the partners who made it possible to issue this challenge. We just ask for increase for them, 30, 60, 100-fold. And for those watching, making decisions right now, be with them. Let your peace be upon them. For we ask it all in Jesus' name. Amen. $67,400 on the challenge, 40 minutes on the clock. We need to hear from you. What are we asking you to do? We're asking you to join the 700 Club. How much is that? It's just $20 a month, 65 cents a day. And you join with tens of thousands of people that want to make a difference in the world today, that want to help people, that want to be a blessing to others. So if that's you, give us a call right now, 1-800-759-0700. Terry?
Well, when you join the 700 Club, we want to send you Pat Robertson's latest DVD, Be Healed. Here's a preview of this dynamic new teaching.
Pat Robertson recently recorded a very special program to answer the question, does God still heal today?
What we're trying to do here, Scott, is to tell people how they can access the power of the living God through Jesus Christ.
Discover the answers and let your faith be encouraged.
And then Jesus spelled out of how we can have healing and how we can have miracles.
In Pat Robertson's latest DVD, Be Healed, you'll learn the biblical basis for healing today, how to exchange anxiety and worry for faith and confidence, the way to pray for your healing and healing for those you love. Plus, meet real people who've experienced the miraculous healing power of God.
The first thing I did was reached out for a lifesaver. And that was God. You know, you can put your trust in medicine, but the ultimate healing is going to have to be God.
Find out the biblical principles that lead to healing in Pat Robertson's latest teaching, Be Healed. Available now.
God loves you so much. He wants wholeness in your life, and we want to help you get there from here. So many of you call, and you know it's our privilege to pray with you year-round. Well, today, we're asking you to help us help others. When you join the 700 Club, our way of saying thank you to you is to send you Be Healed, and we think this is going to be a wonderful blessing in your life. So go to your phone and call right now. As Gordon said just a moment ago, every dollar you pledge right now will be matched dollar for dollar, so your gift will go twice as far in making a difference. Great time to call 1-800-759-0700. Gordon?
Well, no matter how hard he worked, Aaron Martin could barely pay the mortgage or even put dinner on the table. Then one day, Aaron stopped asking God for help, and instead he said a simple prayer. God, what can I do for you? Almost instantly, Aaron got an answer that changed his life.
CBN partner Aaron Martin always looks forward to his wheat harvest.
There's no feeling like it in completion and bringing your crop in.
Aaron didn't start to farm until 2011. Before that, he was a lumber salesman working on commission.
Everything was going well until the housing market took a dump and my commission went with it. Things started getting kind of ugly. I didn't know from one week to the next how we were going to afford propane or house payment.
Within 3 months, the couple was barely making it.
When your wife comes to you and she's like, we need groceries this week and we don't have the money, you know, stress really starts to hit you.
I couldn't even plan like spaghetti because we didn't have any noodles.
Wanting to provide for his wife and two children, Aaron doubled his efforts at work, but didn't see any increase in his paychecks.
It would break my heart that he, you know, because he always felt like he was a failure.
After months of defeat, Aaron knew something needed to change.
I was like, Lord, what can I do for you? And what is your path for me? And how can I get closer to you? And he instantly laid on my heart about, well, then obey me and tithe.
The couple had discussed tithing before, but Aaron always opted to spend money on other things. Now he just wanted to please God. So he and Sabrina immediately tithed off of their small income, and God provided for their needs.
We got a check in the mail from the government of a tax credit, which was more than sufficient for groceries plus more. I told my wife right then and there, I said, this is just the beginning of how God's gonna bless my obedience to him. The very next month, I had the biggest commission check I ever had, actually, even when things were good. In one check, I made $7,000.
The Martins tithed off of that check and every paycheck since.
The more we tithed, the more blessings we received.
Soon, Aaron was able to start farming full time.
The business exploded in 3 years. I've gone from a tractor and a drill to multiple equipment, my own farm ground, and over 1,000 acres of custom farming just all here locally. This is totally from the favor of God.
Today, the Martins don't have any personal debt and soon will have paid off all of their farm equipment.
I honestly believe we wouldn't be here where we're at today if we hadn't have started tithing.
It's hard to let go. If you can make that first step, as I did, and give that first 10% off the top and stay faithful to him, he will stay faithful to you.
If you're faithful to him, he will stay faithful to you. I challenge you to ask the same prayer. Ask God the same question. God, what do you want me to do for you? How can I be a part of your plan? How can you use me? When you get into that mode of prayer, that's when the blessings come. And I love Aaron's faith. He said, this is just the beginning. When the first results came in, he said, this is just the beginning. God has no limits. If you want to test God, that's the only time we get to test him is with our finances. If you want to test him, call us now, 1-800-759-0700. Just say, I want to be a part of everything you're doing around the world. I want to help people. I want to feed the poor. I want to provide medical missions. I want to provide cleft palate surgeries. I want to help orphans. I want to preach the gospel around the world. If you want to do that, join the 700 Club. Call us now, 1-800-759-0700. Let's go to Wendy at the phones. Wendy?
Thanks, Gordon. Well, have you ever received a bad diagnosis? When Vera Kirkpatrick was diagnosed with leukemia, she thought she was getting a death sentence, and so did her doctors. But God had other plans for Vera, and you can see her story and more on our new DVD, Be Healed. Take a look.
Does God heal leukemia?
I've got some bad news. And I said, what's the bad news? He goes, I think you have leukemia. And he said, what's worse? I think you have about 2 weeks to live.
Healed.
I've never seen anything like Vera. I've never seen anybody recover so quickly and so profoundly.
You can put your trust in medicine, but the ultimate healing is going to have to be God.
Discover how God still heals today in Pat Robertson's latest teaching, Be Healed.
The ultimate healing has to be God. Reminds me of that song, you've probably heard it too. Whose report are you going to believe? I'm going to believe the report of the Lord. Now, we love our doctors and we thank God for them, but isn't it nice to know that Jesus has the final say? He is our great physician. Well, it's time to believe God for your healing again. We want to encourage you with that, with Pat's great new teaching called Be Healed. How to see miracles of healing in your life and maybe some people that you're praying for as well. This is our gift to you when you call right now and just say, yes, I want to join the 700 Club. How much is that? Great question. Just 65 cents a day, $20 a month to do so much around the world, as Gordon was just mentioning. The number's right there on your screen, or you can log on to CBN.com. It's another great way to give. Now, if you're already a CBN partner, that's our $20 a month level. Thank you so much. We are so appreciative of what you're doing, and we know you're being blessed, but I'd like to encourage you to take it up to the next level. Our gold level, that's $40 a month. We're going to bless you back with three DVDs, one for you and two to give away. And if you can do more, a lot of us can. Let's take it up to $84 a month. That's our 1,000 club level. We're going to bless you with five DVDs. So this is our gift to you when you give us a call right now. Terry.
Well, one of the most precious moments for any father is hearing his child say daddy for the first time. For one man in China, that moment was especially sweet because his daughter was deaf.
Grandma Lee takes care of her granddaughter, Shaw Nan, because her parents both have irreversible health problems. Grandma Lee will never forget the day she almost lost Shaw Nan.
We were holding hands, just taking a walk. And all of a sudden, Shaw Nan ran into the road. I heard a loud car horn, but my granddaughter acted like she did not hear it. I raced after her as fast as I could to keep her from getting hit.
The Lees took Shaw Nan to a doctor who said she had damaged nerves in both ears and couldn't make out a single sound.
Both my husband and I are illiterate. Now my daughter would be illiterate too. She would never be able to find a job or get married.
Shaw Nan needed a hearing aid and language training, but that would cost nearly $4,000.
I only make $340 a month. I would never be able to afford what my daughter needed.
Still, Grandma Lee refused to give up hope. She's a Christian and often prayed to God for help.
I said, Father, you know how desperately Shaw Nan needs a hearing aid. You let her be born this way. So I am believing that you will make a way for her. Please do something.
Then a friend told the Lees about CBN, and we offered to pay for a hearing aid and a full year of language training for Shaw Nan. One of her first words was Daddy.
I heard it, and I cried. Thank you so much for stretching out your hands to help my daughter.
Now my daughter will be able to find a job and get married. I am so happy for her. You know what the best thing is? Something very special has happened in Shaw Nan's heart. Since Sabian helped her, she has put her trust in the Lord and always says Amen at the end of our prayers. Thank you to everyone who helped to change Shaw Nan's life and gave our family hope.
That grandmother just kind of says it all, doesn't she? You gave the family hope. You changed the life of this little girl. 700 Club members are doing that every day of the year, all around the world. We have opportunities to make a difference, to make a change, and that's why today we're asking you to be a part of that. If you already have joined the 700 Club, would you consider going up to the next club level? Let me show you the choices and options that you have. A general 700 Club membership is $20 a month. That breaks down to $0.65 a day. You could go up to the 700 Club Gold level, that's $40 a month. Our 1,000 Club members join us at $84 a month. 2,500 Club members, $209 a month. And our founders join us at $417 a month. That turns out to be $5,000 a year. Or you could consider the Chairman's Circle. These are friends that give gifts of $10,000 or more a year. Ask God what He'd have you to do, and then call, knowing that you are joining an army of people who are out to make a difference in the lives of others, and as you saw with Shaw Nan, bringing the message of God's love to them and to their families and communities. So call now, 1-800-759-0700. Gordon?
For a miner in Indonesia, a hard day's work doesn't necessarily mean a steady paycheck. On a good day, he could earn $10. On a bad day, he earns nothing at all.
Every morning before sunrise, Tanner sets out on a wooden boat to a platform where he dredges for tin ore on the ocean floor. It's a process called marine mining.
If I find up to 10 kilos of tin ore, I can bring home $10. If I find 5 kilos, I only bring home around $3. There's no certainty in tin mining. Sometimes we get a lot, sometimes we get nothing.
And bringing home nothing means another day of waiting and wondering if they'll ever be able to afford the surgery to repair their son's cleft palate. Tanner's wife, Nur, was actually born with a cleft palate too. Years ago, a relative paid for her surgery.
I think it will take a long time to save because my husband doesn't earn too much.
Then one day, a village official told the couple that a team of doctors was coming from CBN. Tanner and Nur registered Rama, and soon a surgeon repaired the baby's cleft lip. A few months later, we went back to the family's home. Not only did Rama's lip look better, he was finally gaining weight too.
Now, when he drinks milk, the milk no longer seeps into his nose. Oh, he looks so different now. Now I can say that my son is handsome.
To the people who helped Rama, big thank you. You have done for us and for our son what we could never do.
You have done for us what we could never do. And when you do that, when you help people in need, God notices and he will provide for you. Here's the promise from Proverbs chapter 28. He who gives to the poor will not lack. That's a promise, and that's a promise from Almighty God. You can bank on it. If you want to do that, if you want to say, I want to be a part of it, I want to be a part of helping people in Indonesia, I want to be a part of helping people in China, I want to be a part of helping people right here in America, all of that is possible when you join the 700 Club. So go to the phone and call us, 1-800-759-0700. What are we asking for? It's just $20 a month, 65 cents a day to join the 700 Club. Some of you say, I can join at a higher level. We have 700 Club Gold for you, which is $40 a month. 1,000 Club is $1,000 a year, and that breaks out to $84 a month. At whatever level, God is speaking to you, now's the time to give. Now, can I get a drum roll? I've got some great news. Some CBN partners from Texas are saying the challenge is not enough. They want to add $125,000 to it. That takes us all the way up to $192,000. Let's pray. Lord, we ask for a blessing from the partners in Texas who made it possible to increase this challenge. And we just ask for them that there would be no lack, that you would open the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing they cannot contain. And for those watching, making decisions, let your peace be multiplied to them, your grace, your peace, and let them know that you have their future. We ask it all in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
192,000 on a challenge, 25 minutes on the clock. We need to hear from you. Call us now, 1-800-759-0700. Let's go to Wendy at the phones. Wendy?
All right, thanks, Gordon. Well, when Daniel Fazzino went to the doctor, he got a shocking diagnosis. He only had 3 months to live. Well, that was 13 years ago, and you can see Daniel's miraculous story on our new DVD, Be Healed. Take a look.
You know, you hear the word cancer, and you just automatically associate it with death and dying.
When they took that second scan, they were just hoping the tumor would be smaller, and it came back completely negative, like just gone.
My name is Daniel Fazzina, and God healed me of cancer, a cancer that doctors said could have killed me within months to even weeks. My story is included in Pat Robertson's new DVD, Be Healed, and I encourage you to watch it, be touched by God, and receive your own miracle.
Available now.
I love that scripture out of Psalm 103 where God says, I will forgive all of your sins and heal all of your diseases, all of them. You know, Jesus didn't turn anyone away. He healed everyone who came to him, and he hasn't changed. Jesus is the same today as he was then. So I want to encourage you today for your healing, and we have just the thing for you. It's Pat's new teaching called Be Healed, How to Pray for Your Miracle. This is yours when you give us a call right now and just say, yes, I want to join the 700 Club. 1-800-759-0700, or you can log on to cbn.com. If you're already a partner at $20 a month, thank you so very much. We can't do it without you. But it's a brand new year. You probably need a new challenge like I do. Let's take it up to the next level, $40 a month. That's our gold level. When you go there, guess what? We're going to bless you back with three DVDs, one for you and two to give away to friends and family. Now, if you can do more, a lot of us can, let's take it up to our 1,000 Club level or even higher. We have many levels here at CBN. The 1,000 Club level is just $84 a month. We're going to bless you back with five DVDs. Now, we are in the middle of a $192,000 challenge. That means that every dollar that you pledge right now will be matched dollar for dollar. So please don't delay. Go to your phones right now. Gordon.
Well, as a fitness trainer, Danny Kaczmarek works hard to keep himself in great shape. But his finances were a different story. At one point, Danny had racked up $75,000 in debt.
Getting people moving. That's what Danny Kaczmarek's business is all about. He does that with a mix of aerobics, weightlifting, and full body exercises.
Well, my goal as a personal trainer is definitely to get people healthy.
But Danny told us his finances were anything but healthy. Between consumer spending and other debt, he and his wife were $75,000 in the hole.
We basically charged everything. We didn't own anything. From the cars, to the TVs, to a new bed, to furniture for our new home. We didn't want to wait. We just wanted it now.
The stress of this mountain of debt weighed heavily on Danny, who saw no way out.
It's like a black cloud hanging over me, literally. Because at the time, you know, you're looking at your finances that are coming in and what you owe and what needs to go out. It was impossible.
Then in 2009, Danny started tithing and giving to CBN after hearing a message on the internet and watching Pat teach about giving on the 700 Club.
God turned me into a giver, turned me into a giver. It has been relentless giving ever since, never missed at all. As far as I can remember, since 2009, we've been giving absolutely every week of every month, of every year.
Danny says he saw God's provision when he landed a full-time job managing a fitness training program for a large company.
When you start to give, God starts to give. It's like this exchange that is supernatural. I really can't explain it in words because tithing just flies in the face of reality.
A year later, when that job ended, Danny started doing his personal training business full-time with outside clients.
In the first year, probably a 70% gain. And then going into 2013, it doubled. And it's been that way ever since.
Since going out on his own, Danny says he runs his business using a simple motto: pay God, pay his debt, and lastly, pay himself. He does most of his giving online.
He and I feel I'm just on it. It's just very consistent, just like training. Consistency with giving, consistency with anything is gonna lead to results.
Danny soon plans to open his own gym where he lives in Dallas.
All I can say, that's a favor of God. I mean, I don't know where this come from. I didn't ask for it. I wasn't looking for it.
He's also been able to pay off over half of his $75,000 of debt.
This is a mountain 4 years ago. I mean, a mountain where there's no way out. And all of a sudden, it starts to disappear. Dude, it's amazing. Tithing just doesn't make any sense to the world. It doesn't make any sense to some people in the church, but they gotta get it. They gotta trust. You gotta give, you gotta give, you gotta give. You become a giver, God reciprocates. And it's been that way nonstop.
It's counterintuitive, but it works. It's the law of reciprocity. That's what we call it. And these are the words of Jesus: give, and it will be given unto you. Doesn't seem to make sense to our natural mind, but in God's economy, in God's universe, it works. Give, and it will be given unto you. If you want to start doing that, give us a call, 1-800-759-0700. Just say, yes, I want to join the 700 Club. It's just $20 a month, 65 cents a day, and you join tens of thousands of people that want to make a difference in the world today. If that's you, call us now. And when you call, ask for Pledge Express. That's electronic monthly giving, where the bank does all the work and there are no checks to write. We save so much on the processing, we can send Power for Life monthly teaching CDs to you. So if you like those, ask for Pledge Express when you call, or just log on to CBN.com, and when you give monthly on the giving page, you automatically sign up for Pledge Express. Do it now, 1-800-759-0700. Terry?
Well, this year, CBN's animated program, Superbook, will share the gospel in 42 different languages around the world. These Bible stories are already changing the lives of literally millions of children, like this young boy in Costa Rica.
My favorite episode is in the beginning. I've seen it 24 times. My favorite scene is when the angels fought in the name of the Lord God.
11-year-old Luis Felipe is a diehard Superbook fan. He first started watching the CBN animated series when it aired in Costa Rica last year. He was so taken by the Bible stories that he begged his mom to buy the DVDs for him. But Luis and his mom weren't prepared for the impact it would have on his life. During the story of Abraham and Isaac, for example, Luis became so troubled that he had to leave the room.
When I saw the story of Abraham and his son Isaac, I was sad. He was going to sacrifice what he loved most in the world.
He went out into the hallway and kept asking, why? Why?
During another episode, Luis made a life-changing decision.
While watching Superbook, I asked Jesus to come into my heart and stay with me forever.
According to his mom, Rebecca, God has used Superbook to change her son's behavior, too.
The change in Felipe has been incredible. I have seen him seeking more of God, being obedient, reading the Bible, and praying at night. Sometimes for me, my daughter, for our family.
Something in my heart was missing. And when I watched Superbook, that space was filled, because Superbook has helped me face my problem.
Even the neighbors have noticed a difference in Luis.
The way he talks is something sweet to see in a boy. And it is clear that he has become interested in the things of God.
I would tell parents that haven't seen Superbook to sit down with your children and watch it. It is like sowing seeds into fertile ground, and it will help us as well as our kids.
I marvel at how much Superbook is helping children to truly understand the things of God. This little boy so expresses what happens when Christ comes into the heart of someone, adult or child. It's amazing, and you can be a part of that. Superbook is one of the many programs that go out to people around the world, but this is touching the children of the nations, and we thank you. If you're a 700 Club member, you're a part of that. You're making that happen. So we ask you to go to your phone right now. We're in the middle of a challenge. It means when you go to your phone and call, everything that you pledge right now will be matched dollar for dollar, and so we want you to do that. We also ask, would you consider giving your pledge using Pledge Express? That's electronic monthly giving. It means your bank does all the work, but it's pretty wonderful. You don't have to have stamps or envelopes, don't have to remember to send anything. It's all done for you. It does save us some processing costs so that we can put even more of your gift into the lives of children like Felipe. So we say thank you, and our way of literally saying thank you to you is we want to send you psalms of encouragement for using Pledge Express. Pat's gone into the studio here and he's taken some of our favorite psalms, put them to beautiful music as he reads them, and I think this will be a real blessing to you. And then every month thereafter, you're going to receive Power for Life teachings. These are teachings we receive corporately here at CBN, and we'd like to share them with you. We think they'll be a great blessing. So there's the number, 1-800-759-0700. Just call and say, I want to join the 700 Club, and I want to do it using Pledge Express. Gordon?
Well, in the Congo, a wonderful woman named Georgette runs a home for orphans. She does everything she can to give the children a good life, so we decided to help her with the one thing she couldn't give them, clean drinking water.
Of all the kids at this children's home, Peter is the one who loves to study the most.
God blessed me with a good brain, and I want to use it.
After his father left the family, Peter's mother abandoned him, and he was left to fend for himself. Georgette Niembo runs the children's home and helps all 50 of her kids with their schoolwork. But even as much as Peter loves to study, he had trouble with school. He spent many of his mornings walking miles to a dirty stream and carrying a heavy jug of water home.
I was very tired by the time I got back home, and I was always late to school.
Then CBN, in partnership with Innovation Africa, dug a deep well right next to the children's home. The system utilizes technology developed in Israel. Solar panels power the well pump, which in turn provides water for drinking and for a drip irrigation system.
As soon as we got the well, I felt like a heavy burden had been lifted from my shoulders. Now we have fresh, clean water and a garden too. I'm never late for school. I have plenty of time for reading, studying, and playing soccer with my friends.
Peter is at the top of his class. He doesn't know what he wants to be when he grows up, but he does have a clear goal.
I don't want too much. I just want enough to support myself with a little extra left over to help others.
With a deep well right next to the children's home, that simple goal is well within his reach.
I would like to say thank you to the people who helped us. I pray that God will bless their children just as much as He has blessed us.
Peter, what a wonderful young man. And just imagine him growing up to have a hope and a future, all because of some very simple things. The ability to have running water, the ability to have a stable food source, the simple things, the fundamentals, the basics. And you provided it for him, so he now has a future. He can start studying and doing well in school and dreaming of a wonderful future. If you want to be a part of what we're doing, all you have to do is join the 700 Club. Go to the phone. Call us right now, 1-800-759-0700. We're in the middle of a challenge. It's $192,400, so be a part of it. Be matched right now. 12 minutes and 13 seconds left in it. We need to hear from you. Call us now, 1-800-759-0700. Let's go to Wendy at the phones. Wendy?
Thanks, Gordon. Well, the Bible is full of stories of miraculous healings, but does God still do miracles today? Pat Robertson answers that question and more in his new DVD, Be Healed. Here's a look at some of the inspiring stories that you'll see.
Does God still heal today?
Some people it ends in death. Some people the sickness runs a course of like 25 years.
And I'm laying there just, you know, propped up. I looked at him, I said, God just healed me.
I heard the report of the aneurysm. I knew that things were very, very grave. I'm grateful that I have my husband back, my best friend.
I was saying, I'm burning, I'm burning. My husband was awakened by my screams. I have absolutely no symptoms.
In Pat Robertson's latest DVD, Be Healed, you'll learn the biblical basis for healing today, how to exchange anxiety and worry for faith and confidence, the way to pray for your healing and healing for those you love. Plus, meet real people who've experienced the miraculous healing power of God.
You can put your trust in medicine, but the ultimate healing is going to have to be God.
Find out the biblical principles that lead to healing in Pat Robertson's latest teaching, Be Healed.
And what's so interesting about the stories on this DVD is that a lot of these healings didn't happen overnight. In fact, some took years, but people kept praying, they kept believing, and they got their miracle. Well, maybe you've told yourself or other people have told you, you're just going to have to live with it. Well, that's not what the Bible says. By His stripes, we are healed. Jesus healed everyone who came to Him. I want to help you believe again with your miracle to be healed. This is Pat's new teaching, how to experience God's healing power. This is yours when you call us right now and just say yes. I want to join the 700 Club. It's just 65 cents a day, $20 a month. Now, if you're already a CBN partner at that $20 a month level, thank you so much. We can't do it without you. It takes all of us working together to make such a big difference. But I'd like to challenge you to go up to the next level. That's our gold level at $40 a month. When you go there, we want to bless you with 3 DVDs, 1 for you and 2 to give away. And if you can do more, let's take it up to the 1,000 Club level. That's just $84 a month. And we have many higher levels here at CBN. We're going to bless you back with 5 DVDs. Now, we're in the middle of a $192,000 challenge with just 9 minutes and 42 seconds left on the clock. So this is the time we need your help. Terry?
Nearly 2 million of Kenya's children are orphans, like 12-year-old Edmund. When we met him, Edmund was hitching rides on buses, sleeping on the streets, and eating garbage from the dump.
Edmund always dreamed of becoming a doctor, but when his parents died, the 12-year-old was sent to work.
I went to town to sweep houses and shops and to collect scrap metal to sell. I gave the money to my grandmother.
Edmund was always hungry, and no one looked after him.
My life was so hard, I couldn't stand it anymore. I saw a bus coming, so I snuck on it and hid under a chair.
He slept on the streets and ate garbage from the dump with the other homeless children. Then he saw some kids who looked happy. The children were from an orphanage supported by CBN's Orphans Promise.
When we noticed him, we asked him to stay and share the food we had.
Here at the orphanage, more than 50 children have been rescued from wars and poverty.
We love them all, so we teach them about God and instill Christian values in their hearts.
We make sure they do well in school, so they can be independent one day and have a good quality of life.
Edmund is just happy to have a home.
I feel good here because I have food to eat, water to drink, and clothes to wear. Before I came to this home, I did not know who Jesus was, but I met him here.
I look at a child like Edmund, so lost in the circumstances of life. No one to belong to, no one looking out for him. And then, because you made it possible to have a children's home there, there's a place for Edmund. The Bible says God puts the lonely in families. This is a beautiful young boy with a huge future ahead of him, and you are investing in him. That means you're investing in his country. That means you can change the future of people. We just want to say thank you for caring enough to do that. When you go to your phone and call right now and join the 700 Club, you become a part of Edmund's life and thousands of children like him that we are investing in. And when you use Pledge Express, that means that even more of your gift goes into the lives of children like Edmund and all of the other work that we do, drilling wells, making education available to kids, keeping families together, Superbook, all of the many projects that go out from CBN. We're going to say thank you for using Pledge Express by sending you Psalms of Encouragement. We want you to have this. You can listen to it in your car during your quiet time. And then every month you'll get powerful for life teachings that will also be a blessing to you. So when you bless others, we want to bless you and say thank you. Our number's toll-free, 1-800-759-0700. Gordon?
All right, I've got some great news. Some partners from North Carolina want to add to this challenge. They want to add 61,000 to it. That takes us up to 253,400. Let's pray. Lord, we ask for blessing. We ask for encouragement. We ask for wisdom. We ask for creative ideas. For the partners who made it possible to increase this challenge. And for those watching, making decisions right now, be with them, speak to them. For we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
253,000 on that challenge. We need to hear from you, so go to the phone and call us. 1-800-759-0700. Just say, yes, I want to join the 700 Club. In parts of the Philippines, you can go miles without finding a doctor. And for one man living there, that lack of medical care nearly cost him his leg.
Jerry knew he was in trouble when a truck ran over his foot. At first, it swelled and later became infected. After a month, it was not getting better.
I no longer know what to do. My foot was not healing.
Where Jerry lives in the Philippines, there are no doctors or nurses. So he was grateful when a free CBN mobile medical clinic came to his town. He quickly lined up to be treated.
I was afraid I would no longer walk normally again.
At the medical mission, a doctor examined his foot, and then a nurse cleaned and dressed the wound. We then gave Jerry antiseptic, creams, and medications to fight infection. CBN's Dr. Aquino said Jerry arrived just in time.
He could lose his leg if the wound infection had spread all over his body.
Jerry was just one of nearly 400 people that CBN treated that day.
We are very grateful to CBN for coming to help us. You brought us good medicines and doctors. Thank you. Thank you very much.
That's what you do when you're a member of the 700 Club. If you are a member, thank you. You're part of that medical mission. You're part of saving that man's leg. And if you're not a member, join with us. Join in everything we're doing. 1-800-759-0700. Terry?
You know, in Western India, it doesn't take much to start a small business. In fact, for one desperate family, all it took was a pair of goats.
Savita and her husband raised livestock to support their family in Western India. But then Savita and her children got very sick. They sold everything they owned, including their animals, to pay for medicine and witch doctors.
I thought our daughters would have to drop out of school and work as day laborers so we could survive.
That's when they heard about Jesus Christ from a local pastor.
My family and I put our complete faith in Jesus Christ as our one true God. We prayed to him and he healed my family and me.
Then we prayed that Jesus would help us with our finances.
CBN found out about Savita's family through their pastor. We helped them restart their business by giving them a pair of goats.
We are so happy that you blessed us with two goats. We will breed them and sell the extra goats to pay for our living expenses.
God was faithful to us and answered our prayers. Now that you blessed us with these goats, my family will have lots of milk to drink, and my daughters can continue to go to school. You really helped our family.
That is a holistic approach to giving a family hope and a future, and you make it possible. We say thank you, 700 Club members. We need you to call right now. We're in the middle of a big challenge, and so when you call, everything you give gets matched dollar for dollar. What a blessing that will be for us, but also for you, because you are making a huge difference in the lives of people around the world. Gordon?
When 9-year-old Rudy developed a life-threatening hernia, his parents were told he needed surgery. But with an income of just $75 a month, they knew they could never afford it.
Until recently, Rudy was an active child. Like many 9-year-olds, soccer was his passion, but his mom worries every time he plays.
There was a big lump on his stomach which pushed through his navel.
Rudy suffered with an umbilical hernia, where a part of his intestine pushes through a weakness in the stomach wall.
It really hurt.
Rudy's parents took their son to the doctor but couldn't afford the corrective surgery that was needed.
I went home and cried and wondered how we could save enough to get an operation for our son.
Both of Rudy's parents make bricks for a living at a company near their home, but their combined income is only $75 a month. A short time later, CBN provided Rudy with free surgery to repair the dangerous hernia. A few weeks after that, he was back playing soccer and in perfect health.
I am happy. I can play now. No more pain.
I want to say thanks to everyone who had helped me.
Thanks to everyone that helped me. You can be a part of helping people. You can be a part of helping people around the world. You can be part of Superbook, telling the children of the world the stories of the Bible. You can be a part of preaching the gospel and telling testimonies of what Jesus is doing in their country today. You can be a part of all of it if you just join the 700 Club. Call us now, 1-800-759-0700. We want to go way over the top on this challenge. Let's go over to Wendy at the phones. Wendy?
Well, ask any doctor and he'll tell you there's no cure for Lyme disease. But one young woman will give you a different answer from personal experience, and you can see her story and much more in Pat's new teaching, Be Healed. Watch this.
Does God heal Lyme disease?
I didn't walk for almost 2 years. It was a very difficult and terrifying situation to be in.
Healed.
God has done some amazing work in my life. I'm doing better health-wise than I have been, I think, pretty much ever. And that's because of what God has done.
Discover how God still heals today in Pat Robertson's latest teaching, Be Healed.
It's been a glorious day. We're counting down to victory, and we had a tremendous $253,000 challenge, and against that you gave $265,000.
Yes. Thank you.
We leave you today with these words from 1 Corinthians. Thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. For all of you called today and gave, may God bless you abundantly.
Pat Robertson recently recorded a very special program to answer the question, does God still heal today?
What we're trying to do here, Scott, is to tell people how they can access the power of the living God through Jesus Christ.
Discover the answers and let your faith be encouraged.
And then Jesus spelled out of how we can have healing and how we can have miracles.
In Pat Robertson's latest DVD, Be Healed, you'll learn the biblical basis for healing today. How to exchange anxiety and worry for faith and confidence. The way to pray for your healing and healing for those you love. Plus, meet real people who've experienced the miraculous healing power of God.
The first thing I did was reached out for a lifesaver. And that was God. You know, you can put your trust in medicine, but the ultimate healing is going to have to be God.
Find out the biblical principles that lead to healing in Pat Robertson's latest teaching, Be Healed. Available now. Does God heal lymphoma?
The doctor came back and he said, well, we found something, and it's a rather large mass in your chest. And he said, this is very serious. It was, as he feared, lymphatic cancer.
healed.
Halfway through the treatments, when they took that second scan, which they were just hoping the tumor would be smaller, and it came back completely negative, just gone.
Find out how God still heals today in Pat Robertson's latest teaching, Be Healed, available now.